Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is getting to know the plants. You see, students, we already had discussed about the different parts of the plant, and that different parts of the plant in which we studied about the roots as well as the stem of the plant. Roots, basically, it is having some functions and. You know that because of its role, like absorption of the water and holding the soil as well as holding the plants, makes this a very important part for the plants. If we talk about the stem, students, so stem is what? It is a connection between the roots and that of the leaves. As well as it helps, so connections which help in carrying the water mineral as well as the food to the different parts of the plant. If we talk about the leaves, students, so in the previous class also we were talking about the leaves, that what is the function of the leaves and what are the different components which involve in the process of photosynthesis and how leaves they perform the process of transpiration also. So we are knowing that if we say the function of the leaves, so leaves basically it help in performing the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis occurred in the leaf itself, and this is a process by which the plants they use to prepare the food. So you can say the food preparation process occurred in the leaves. Okay, and that is photosynthesis. So leaves are important to perform the process of photosynthesis. So how and why we can say that this process occurs, student? It occurs because the process of photosynthesis, it needs energy, and that energy. That energy plants get from the sunlight only. So you see, if I am saying that for the process of photosynthesis, plant need energy, and that energy it get it from the sunlight. Now sunlight is exposed to all the part of the plant. So why only the leaves are there which used to prepare the food, not the other part? So you see, student, because leaves are having a pigment, and that is chlorophyll. And what is the role of the chlorophyll in the leaves? So its role is to trap the energy. So when it trap the energy, that energy will be used up by the plant to carry or to complete the process of photosynthesis. So we can say that because of the presence of a chlorophyll, it performs photosynthesis. And the role of a chlorophyll, that it help in trapping the sunlight. Because you see, students, the different parts of the plant, they also receive water, they also receive the sunlight. So why the process of photosynthesis is not carried by the stem of the plant or by the roots of the plant? Why only with the leaves of the plant and especially the green part of the plant? So it is because the green part, it means that portion consisting of a chlorophyll. If any of, even in the young plant also, students, you have seen that the stem of the young plant is green in color. So if it is green in color, it means it consisting of a chlorophyll in it. And if it is having chlorophyll, it will perform the photosynthesis. Because chlorophyll is having a role or having a function that it used to trap the sunlight. So when it used to trap the sunlight, and the sunlight, it means the energy which is coming from that of the sunlight, and this energy is finally used by the leaves to which help in the process of photosynthesis or help in the preparation of the food. So we have studied that what are the different components which is the part of the photosynthesis and how plant they receive it. Finally, students, we all are knowing that not only this, but leaves, they also perform a process of transpiration. What is a transpiration? Basically, if you see the transpiration, so transpiration, you can say it is a kind of an evaporation of a water through leaves. Evaporation of water through leaves. So because of that, since evaporation pollination is occurring from the plants also. So we can say that these water vapor also help in the rainfall. So it also helps in the occurrence of that of the rainfall. You all are knowing that rainfall occurs due to the evaporation process, and in this process transpiration also take part, because there also the process of evaporation occur, but this time the process of evaporation occur with the help of the leaves. Okay, so this is about the process of transpiration. Now you see, student, we are saying that two processes are there. One is photosynthesis and transpiration, which is performed by the leaves only. Now let us try to understand that how it is true. Okay, by checking it. So if you see, student, the first one. So we have to see that the components of the photosynthesis, the raw material, like you see, student, sunlight is there, chlorophyll is very important, or the leaves, they perform the photosynthesis only. So if we want to check that why only the leaves, or how can we say that the leaves only perform the photosynthesis, so we have to do an experiment, and with the help of that we are able to understand it. Okay, so let us write about that experiment, students, and that is leaves makes food for the photosynthesis. Leaves make food for the process of photosynthesis. So see here, student, in this one, the topic is that leaves, they used to prepare food for the process of photosynthesis. So how can you say so that only the leaves are responsible for carrying the photosynthesis? So what we can do an activity, and with the help of which we can understand it. So first of all, what you will do, at first you will pluck a leaf from that of a plant, from a potted plant which has been kept outside for several days. Okay, so first of all we will pluck the leaf from that of the plant. Okay, so the first one we can do is pluck. Pluck a leaf from a potted plant which has been kept outside, for several days. So this potted plant should be kept outside so that it could receive the sufficient amount of the sunlight. And what we have to do, we have to pluck a leaf from the same potted plant. Now students, we will take that leaf and keep it in the test tube. Okay, a boiling test tube, we can say, because the boiling test tube, the mouth of that test tube is very wide. Okay, so we will take a test tube and we will roll the leaf and keep it inside. Now in the test tube we will add spirit or alcohol. So we will say that what we can do, we can dip dip that of the leaf with the spirit or with that of the alcohol. Okay, so we can write it. Put the leaf in a test tube and cover it with alcohol so that it get properly dipped into the alcohol. What does it mean, student? It means that we will take a leaf and we will keep the leaf inside to that of the test tube, and when in the test tube the leaf is there, students, then we add a add the spirit or the alcohol in it. Now while adding, you should always remember that we should add the alcohol so that the whole leaf will get properly dipped into it, or we can say we will cover the leaf from that of the alcohol. Okay, so we will cover it with the alcohol. Then the third one, student, now we will take this boiling test tube, or we will take this test tube and keep it in a beaker. Okay, now this beaker consisting of a water in it. Okay, so put this test tube in a beaker which consisting of water in it. Consisting of water in it. So we will take this test tube and keep it in a beaker consisting of the water. And now this setup is ready, student. Test tube consisting of a leaf which is fully dipped with that of the alcohol, and we will take that test tube and keep it in the beaker. That beaker half filled with the water. Now we will take this beaker consisting of the test tube also and keep it on a on that of a burner. Means by taking a tripod stand and keeping a wire watch over it, and then we will keep the beaker. Now what we will do, student, we are simply heating the water which is present in the beaker, and as the water will get heat, the alcohol which is present in the test tube, and the test tube which is dipped in the water, will also get heat up, and the alcohol starts boiling. And due to the boiling of the alcohol, the green color of the leaf, it starts coming out from the leaf itself. Or we can say that due to the boiling of the alcohol makes the leaf decolorize. So it helps in removing the green color from the leaves. So we can write it. That is, now we will take this setup. Setup means test tube in beaker. This beaker consisting of a water, test tube consisting of a leaf, and that of the alcohol in it. So we'll take this setup and heat it by putting it on tripod stand over a burner. Putting it over, burner. Okay, so now what we will do, we will heat it. So because of a heating, student, it starts releasing, we can write it, next one is, as it we can write it that as it starts boiling, as it starts boiling, the green color of the leaf starts coming out and mixes with the alcohol. Okay, green color of the leaf starts coming out, and it mixes with the alcohol. So all the green color student, it starts coming out. Now the leaf become decolorized and that green color will be present in the alcohol. So this green leaf become decolorized now. All the colors which is present in it came out and it get mixed into that of the alcohol. So we can say it mixes with the alcohol and hence the leaf becomes decolorized. It becomes decolorized. Now students, what we will do, we will take out this decolorized leaf and keep it on a plate. First of all, we will wash it with the water and then we will keep this decolorized leaf on a metal plate and then we will add a few drops of iodine solution on it. When you add the few drop of iodine solution on it, it will not going to change its color, it will change its color to blue black. Okay, so as it changes its color to blue black, which proves that it consisting of a starch in it, and thus we can say that leaves they use to prepare the food. Okay, so we can write it, that is become decolorized. Now take out the leaf from the test tube. Now we will take out the leaf from the test tube and wash it with water. Okay, we will take out it from that of the test tube and wash it with water. Wash it with water. Then the next one is, students, that is we will wash it with water and then add few drops of iodine solution on the decolorized leaf. Okay, on that of the decolorized leaf, what will happen to the leaf, student? Leaf changes its color to blue black. Okay, so since it changes the color to blue black, so we can say that proves that it contains starch which conforms the process of photosynthesis occurring in the leaves. Now you see, student, basically what happened, why we are doing this test, we are going to check that the leaves are responsible for preparing the food. Okay, and how we will come to know if the starch will be present in the leaves? So we will say that yes, because starch is what? It is the stored form of food. Okay, so stored form of a glucose, and glucose is the food of the plant. So that is why we can say it is a stored form of a food of the plants. So if starch is present in the leaves, we will say that only leaves are responsible for the preparation of the food. Okay, and how we will come to know that starch is present in it? When we will do the iodine test. And for doing the iodine test, what we have to do, first of all, we have to remove the green color, because that color may produce a hindrance in the blue black color or in that of the iodine test. So for that, students, first of all, we will pluck a leaf and then we have to remove the green color from the leaf. So for that, we will take that leaf and keep it in the test tube. In the test tube, we will fill the test tube with the alcohol. Okay, now alcohol is filled in the test tube. Now what you will do is you'll keep that test tube in the water, which is kept in a beaker. So the beaker is filled with the half filled with that of the water, and we will heat the water. And when the water starts boiling, the test tube which is present in the water and the alcohol which is present in the test tube also starts boiling, and due to which the green leaves it start discharging the color to the alcohol. Now when all the color get discharged, so we will say that it is what it is a we can say that it is a discharged leaf, means is the decolorized leaf, means does not consisting of a color. Now we will take all the take that particular leaf, take it out from the test tube, and then put a few drops of iodine solution on it. Then what we will observe that it changes its color to blue black, and which proves that it consisting of a starch only. Since it is giving the iodine test to students, so it proves that consisting of a starch. And since it is showing the iodine test, since it is explaining that it is having starch in it, so we can say that it performs the process of photosynthesis also. Okay, so process of photosynthesis is performed by the plant itself. So by this, students, we confirm that that leaves, they are responsible for performing the photosynthesis. Now moving on and trying to understand the other thing, that what we are saying that in the process of photosynthesis, sunlight plays a very important role. Okay, so sunlight is very important. How we will come to know, students? So let us write it. Sunlight is necessary for the photosynthesis process, for the process of photosynthesis. So how sunlight is necessary for the process of photosynthesis, students? So you see, if you want to know that whether the sunlight is necessary or not, what you can do, at first you take a potted plant. Okay, now this potted plant which has been kept outside, it has been kept outside, so it is receiving the sufficient amount of a sunlight, and as it is receiving the sufficient amount of a sunlight, that sunlight help in preparing the food, and the food will be stored in the leaves in the form of a starch. So you have to take a potted plant and keep it in a dark where there is no sunlight, and you have to keep that potted plant in dark for about 4 to 5 days. Okay, so first of all we will write it, and then we will try to understand. So the first thing we can do, that we will take a potted plant. That has been kept outside to the sunlight, which is receiving the sufficient amount of a sunlight. Then the second thing, we will keep this potted plant in dark for 4 to 5 days. So why we are keeping it in the dark for 4 to 5 days, students? So that all the starch which is present in that of the plant will be used. Because you see, if suppose it is not getting the sufficient amount of a sunlight, so no process of a photosynthesis will occur. And if no photosynthesis is occurring in the plant, so ultimately, from where it will get the food? It will get the food which the plant has already stored in the leaves. So it will start using the food which is already stored in the plant body. So the starch which is present in the plant is used up by that of the plant. okay, so that is stored food, that is starch, will be used up by the plant. Now as all the starch has been used up by the plant, so no starch is now present. So for 4 to 5 days it will used up all the starch which is present in it and become de-starch. Now what you have to do, student, you have to take a leaf. Don't plug it. It will remain attached to the plant, to the plant only. And in that leaf, if suppose this is a leaf, students, of a one of a plant. Although there are a lot of a leaf, so in that leaf, you have to take only one leaf before keeping it outside. Okay. And at one portion, student, you will cover it with that of the aluminium foil. You should cover it from outside also, means from the upper portion also, from the lower portion also. So here we have taken an aluminium strip and cover it from the both portion, that is from the upper portion and from the lower portion, you can say tightly, so that it will not going to receive any sunlight. Okay, so we can write it, that is, we will take a leaf without plucking it, and cover a portion of a leaf, with the aluminium foil. Okay, now we have covered the leaf with that of the aluminium foil. Now you will keep that pot, students, which is consisting of a leaf and covered with aluminium foil, we will keep it outside in the to that of the sunlight. So at first we de-starch the plant by removing all the starch, by keeping it dark for 4 to 5 days. Then we had covered one of the leaf which is still attached to that of the plant and cover it with that of the aluminium foil. Now we will take that potted plant and keep it outside. When you keep it outside, it will start receiving the sunlight and start making the food. It means the process of photosynthesis occurs again. So we can write it, now keep this potted plant outside so that process of photosynthesis can occur again. After a few days, you will pluck the leaf which you have covered with the aluminium foil. Now, what you will see, students, now what you will do, you will take that leaf and you will again do the process, the same process, by removing the green color with the help of an alcohol, means by burning it, by giving heat to the water and keeping the leaf in the test tube. So, by this, student, we can remove the green color. And then you will take that leaf and put in iodine solution. What will you observe? You will observe that if this is the leaf and that was the aluminium foil, students, now you already had removed the aluminium foil. Now when you put a iodine drop on this surface and to this surface, you will observe that there will be no change in the color of the iodine solution, means it will not going to change into blue black color, but this portion of the leaf changes into the blue color, blue black color. So it proves that this portion consisting of a starch in it, but the portion which was covered with the aluminium strip was does not consisting of a starch in it. And how does it occur, student? Because at first when you had taken the leaf, when you had kept it outside, at that time you already had covered it with the aluminium foil, and because of that this leaf does not receive the sunlight. And since this portion of the leaf does not receive the sunlight, so process of formation of a starch does not occur at this portion. While the other portion was already exposed to the sunlight, so it receives the sufficient amount of a sunlight, and ultimately it is having a sufficient amount of a starch, because the process of photosynthesis keeps on going on these two portions of the leaves. And that is why when you put an iodine solution on these two surfaces, these two part of the leaf surface, then you have seen that there is a change in the color, it changes to blue-black. But since no formation of a starch occur in the portion where you had covered it with the aluminium strip, so that portion will remain the same and there will be no change in the color. So by this, student, we can say that sunlight is necessary for the process of photosynthesis.